in Brooklyn. Her life grew into an after-school routine of skating lessons and ballet class. She excelled at both, but to be a champion, she had to place one pursuit above the rest.
It was difficult, but it was always pretty clear to me that I liked ballet better, that I didn't want to go to the Olympics. I wanted to dance.
She loved dance, but still Healy clung to skating. At age 10, she became the subject of a best-selling book entitled A Very Young Skater. At 11, she turned professional, and under the guidance of her hero, John Curry, she performed in figure skating shows, despite the strong disapproval of her ballet mentors. While a 12-year-old student at the School of American Ballet, Dudley Moore chose her to play his daughter, a young ballerina dying of cancer, in the movie 6 Weeks. At age 14, she won a gold medal at the International Junior Championships, the most prestigious ballet contest in the world. She was offered a principal contract in London, and at the age of 15, had her first taste of life as a prima ballerina.
You know, there was an awful lot of resentment. My peers, I had a senior principal contract, I was 15. My peers were 28 and 30 and 40. There was a lot of resentment.
After 2 years in London, Healy wanted to go home. Her next move scandalized the ballet establishment.
In 86, I was accepted to Princeton, Harvard, and Yale. All the ballet people figured if I went to college, I'd get fat and have a boyfriend, and that would be the end of me. And so it became a mission for me to finish college and to go back to being a principal dancer in a company.
The demands of Princeton and ballet training with a private teacher left no room for skating. When she finished her art history degree, Catherine took an offer from a European company and danced abroad for 7 years, immersing herself in the unforgiving world of ballet.
German word for poison is gift. Some people might think my ability for dancing is a gift, and it was to an extent. Basically, ballet is not a job, it's a lifestyle. It poisons everything you do. You know, it governs what you eat, what you wear, what you say. It's political, it's mean, it's nasty. I took a great beating for a long time, and I ignored it because the trade-off for me was I wanted to dance, I wanted to perform, I wanted to be out there doing these beautiful roles.
After 6 years in Vienna, the pain started to outweigh the rewards. Although she had grown to dislike the lifestyle, the thought of life without ballet was frightening. She returned home and was drawn to the one place she'd always felt safe, the ice. One lesson with Peter Burrows, coach of national pairs champion Ina Ndungen, and she saw her future.
But we had this first lesson, and he said to me, hey, you should skate. You should do some shows.
That's great, Catherine. Good.
And I thought, sure. I didn't think I'd have the nerve.
It wasn't only her dormant figure skating career that was ignited that January day with Burrows. Only 5 months later, their relationship had become a romance.
He asked me out on a date in May, and we had a wonderful time. It was about 8 hours long, and the next day he said, will you come to dinner with me? And I said, yes. He asked me to marry him.
Burrows and Healy married this past September, and Catherine resumed the professional figure skating career she'd begun at age 11. Healy now feels more alive than ever, as if she's been awakened from a bad dream, like the fairy tale princess she once portrayed.
I have a lot of freedom. I don't, you know, I'm not in a ballet company. People can't tell me what to do. You know, I skate, I put my number together, I do the choreography, or I choose the choreographer I want. It's like they let me out of prison for good behavior. I'm so happy.
From ballet slippers to ice skates, Catherine Healy thrilled to be back on the ice once again. She did not compete at this year's Equal Challenge of Champions, but the return of her figure skating career continues now with her special performance.
The music, the prelude, from Tristan und Isolde by Wagner.
And I think she is absolutely a vision of perfection when it comes to body line. And that's what our sport needs right now. Positioning and alignment are so key in skating.
Romeo and Juliet in London. Has been an extraordinary dancer. A graduate of Princeton University. There is nothing that this intelligent, vivacious, outstanding young lady has not done.
This is perfect extension on this beautiful spiral. She has the most extraordinary feet.
She belies the fact that skaters cannot stretch their feet, stretch their legs, and point their toes. Truly the only pure split jumps that we see in the world of skating today.
Very effective move. It's an Ina Bauer with straight legs and the arch in her back. Really exquisite.
Well, I must say that she is just an extraordinary breath of fresh air in the world of skating today.
It's breathtaking to see her, her beautiful line.
She proves that the artistic side of skating, it can be superb. Any one of those moves worth any triple jump.
Prima ballerina Catherine Hewitt, built to skate here in Tampa, Olympic champions.